Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Technical Council's Talk with the Tech Clubs. As a part of this initiative, we are hosting a series of talks with the technical clubs of NIT Trichy to help the students better understand the tech clubs in terms of their projects and vision, their journey and the future ahead for them. This is Mandar and today we'll be having a talk with the Third Dimension. They are the Aeromodeling Club of NIT Trichy, also called 3D, and they model electrically propelled airplanes, drones and hovercrafts. This all sounds really interesting, but what does it actually mean? To help us understand this better, we have with us Abhishek Shankleshwar, President of the Third Dimension.
Yeah, hello, yes. Mandar.
So Abhishek, tell us, what is the Third Dimension all about?
Yeah, as the name goes, Third Dimension, so we deal with motion in third dimension. So we build UAVs, drones, hovercrafts, and we exhibit at various competitions, exhibitions, and for drone research as well. Use it for drone research.
Okay, so all things related to the third dimension. So this will include different profiles, yeah? So what are the profiles that you guys have?
Yeah, we have two profiles as of now, aerodynamics and tronics. So the aerodynamics team basically works with building of RC planes, or we call them gliders. So they basically do analysis of the planes and fabricate the RC planes for all our competitions. And the tronics team basically works on the tronics sides, which includes path planning, image processing, and all other things which makes our UAVs a smarter, more smart.
Okay, and you might be having some major works that you have been doing this past year or in the previous years?
Yeah, our major work is basically building planes, and the most important competition where we took our planes is the SAE competition and the Boeing competition. So every year we actually try to, improve our plane from the previous year and make it more better. So that is what drives us.
Oh, that I remember seeing your Boeing model for the competition, and I was impressed by it. I remember meeting some of you that time. So also I heard that you guys just completed your induction for the current second years. How was it and how did you manage it?
Yeah, as it was the first virtual one, it was challenging, taking all the things online, but I think all of us managed pretty well, and the inductees and all the participants, they also cooperated very well. Yeah, and we feel we have got a best set of people to work with. Yeah.
Wow, that is great. Because I heard that some of the participants didn't have laptops, and you guys managed even with that.
Yeah.
So how was it?
So basically we tried to reach those people who had some problems with the laptops or poor connections, and so we made some special arrangements, we shifted their deadlines or provided some other assistance to them.
So the inductions are done, so how is the virtual onboarding for your juniors?
Yeah, right now, as we do in the initial months of odd semester, so we basically teach our newly inducted juniors about all the stuff they work on. So basically we are trying to teach them all the stuff online platforms Teams, and at the same time we are also giving them some tasks which will make them ready for the competitions.
Okay, so are you looking at some competitions in the near future?
Yeah, for now we have one or two competitions which we have got to know, which we used to participate earlier also, so we just got to know that they will be having a virtual event this time due to the current conditions. So yeah, we are looking forward to that.
Wow, that is great. So apart from this, what is the plan for the third dimension in this virtual semester?
Yeah, apart from these competitions, as all of like as all of us, like we can't go to campus, so we are also trying to undertake some research work related to aerodynamics or fluid mechanics. And also our Tronic teams is like trying to learn new things related to machine learning and swarm of drones, like which can help us in later stage when things normalize. So we're basically trying to learn the skills, trying to use this time to learn
all the skills. All the fields you mentioned were really interesting, like research work in these fields is something that is very interesting at the moment. So can you tell us how was your personal journey with 3D BIM?
Coming to my personal journey, when I started in my inductions, that time I had no technical knowledge of aerospace. Like till that time, like I just liked airplanes, that's it, and I just wanted to enter inductions like just for exploring it. But then as the inductions went, like things which I learned made me realize, like, yeah, this is the thing which I want to have in my career. Like I want to pursue my career in this thing. So, and that actually helped me a lot. And yeah, once I got inducted, I learned even more things after that. Yeah, and learning side by side, I also like made some great bunch of friends. Yeah, so yeah, as I was saying, like while I was learning all the new things like in the club, at the same time I was forming a great bunch of friends, and like I had learned a lot from them as well. And apart from the technical skills, like I also developed my communication skills and management skills alongside. And like now I have reached like that position, like now I'm preparing for my master's for aerospace engineering ahead. So yeah, like it has been a long journey. Like in the first year I had no idea like whether I would be going anywhere in aerospace or not. Now like I'm certain that yeah, I'll pick that field. So like 3D has helped me make that decision.
Wow, like your journey of self-realization is really inspiring to me. You said you learned a lot in terms of management. So like how many hours did you have to put in for 3D in a week?
Like on a weekly basis, like I would say 10 to 15 hours per week.
So did you find it difficult to manage, or did you do it with a breeze?
Like no, I didn't find it that much tough to manage. Like yeah, I had to compromise a little bit here and there, but yeah, it was worth it. Yeah.
Wow, that is so great. So now you're looking forward to your master's in the same field, and we wish you all the best in that. Finally, what would you like to say to our viewers today?
I would say I know many of the people like who choose any other stream in NITs, like because they are not able to get aerospace engineering in any other institute. So like if you are one of them, then I would say 3D is the place where you can learn a lot of aero stuff. And also not just those people like who wanted to have a career in aero. We have a lot of people working, you know, which will not go into aero career, but yeah, the things they are learn will help them shape themselves for different career roles. And also, yeah, like one more thing, like many people ask us like whether we are doing stuff related to rocketry. So about that, we have actually not done anything as of now. And till now also, we have not planned anything related to rockets. We believe we have not, developed that proficiency to touch rockets.
Rocket science is, after all, rocket science. It is a bit different than aero modeling. So with this, we have come to the end of this session. We hope our viewers were able to learn more about the third dimensional aerodynamic aero modeling club. If aero modeling and aerospace is your passion and you wish to learn more about these topics, 3D will be the best choice for you in this campus. I hope everyone was able to follow through with this session today. And thank you, Abhishek, for joining us today. To all our viewers, stay tuned for more such sessions, and till then, stay safe.
Thank you, Mandar, for having me.